Day. Oh my goodness, what day is it? It's Thursday, June 8th, and we're here to have an amazing show. We're glad that you're here. I'm running solo this time with the managing the entering the people and all these things. Both Jeff and Harry are out of town, so you got me. So I'm glad to be here. Welcome. We're very excited. We're introducing two new performers for you this week, and we are starting our show with our very dear friend Caoimhe. So Caoimhe, welcome! Yay, you're here.
I'm
So glad to
here.
see you. There are some people who might have forgotten your background, so I'm going to ask you for a quick introduction, but I'm going to jump off the screen, and it's all yours. All
Perfect.
right, and all you can tell us about you, the better.
Okay.
So have a great set. Love you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I'm so happy to be here again. Jeff's place is my happy place, my safe space for playing music. I'm based over in Ireland, often in different parts of Ireland. At the moment, I'm in County Cork, which is down the south. I work by day as an engineer, but often at night, I don my guitar and go out and play gigs. And even during the day as an engineer, I'm often writing songs in the background in my head, or coming up with melodies, or listening to music as I work. So really deep down, the musician is kind of who I am, I think, who I identify as. I've always been a musician, I think, since I was born. Since I was able to make any noise at all, I would sing along to songs on the radio before I could talk. So I think that kind of sums it up. I'm going to play a few songs for you today, and I'm going to start with an Eva Cassidy version of a song. She didn't write it. It was Sting originally. But I love the way that Eva Cassidy did it. I'm really, really inspired by her vocally and just musically in general. So I really hope you like this version. It's Fields of Gold.
In his jealous sky, when we walked in fields of gold. So she took her love for to gaze a while among the fields of barley. In his arms she fell as her hair came down among the fields of gold. Will you stay with me? Will you be my love among the fields of barley? And you can tell the sun in his jealous sky when we walked in fields of gold. And I never made promises lightly, and there have been some that I've broken, but I swear in the days still left, we will walk in fields of gold. We will walk in fields. I never made promises lightly, and there have been some that I've broken, but I swear in the days still left, we walk in fields of gold. We walk in fields of gold. Have passed since those summer days among the fields of barley. See the children run as the sun goes down, as you lie in fields of gold. You'll remember me when the west wind moves among the fields of barley. You can tell the sun in his jealous sky when we walked in fields of gold. When we walked in fields of gold. When we walked in fields.
Love that song. Was beautiful, Caoimhe. Awesome. Thank you for sharing that one today.
Thank you very much. Thank you for listening.
Well, you know, we got a nice audience in here, and some people that are new to me and some people that are probably here because they want to hear all of you guys. And it's amazing. Not that they're probably here for that. They're definitely here for that. So what do you have for us next, love?
The next song I'm going to play is an original song that a few people may be familiar with. Anyone who's been following Jeff's place and has heard me play before, I play it quite regularly. And I had the pleasure of playing it very recently with Colm in Oris Cronon. He played the piano for it, and it was like a whole other, totally other version of the song. It was the same song, but it just added another element, having another instrument and another musician kind of taking... It's almost like when someone plays your song, it's like they take a little bit of an ownership of it, but in a beautiful way. So yeah, it was really cool.
It was really cool. I did get to hear that recording. It was quite amazing.
There's a little clip of it on Instagram if anyone is good. Interested and wants to
That's
take
a good thing to know. We'll yeah. make sure everybody follows.
So it's called I Don't Like Singing Anymore. It's on Spotify if anyone wants to hear it again after I've played it. Yeah, and thank you so much for listening. Can you hear the guitar okay? Just to check. Yeah. I don't like singing anymore. I don't know what the hell I ever sang for. When it all goes wrong and nothing's right, it don't help me to sleep at night. So I don't like singing anymore. And I don't like talking anymore. I don't know what the hell I ever talked for. When all the words I have to say won't change or take the pain away, I won't bother talking anymore. And I don't feel like dancing anymore. My mind is low, my legs are weak, my heart is sore. Since the blues have moved into my brain, I sleep away another day. I don't like dancing anymore.
And I don't like living anymore. I've forgotten all the things I used to live for. When the pain is all that I can see, just don't make no sense to me. So I don't like living anymore. And I don't like singing anymore. I don't know what the hell I ever sang for, till I saw that look in your eye, and it seemed like things might be alright. So I guess I could keep singing till I'm sure.
Thank you.
I love that one.
I love playing it live.
Yeah, playing it live is great, but it's, you know, when you sang it here for the very first time, I started to cry because I was like, no, you can't do that. You gotta keep going.
Well, sometimes people joke with me, so there's two different reactions I'll get. So I'll either get someone being like, oh my God, you don't like anything. Like, I don't like anything anymore. Or I'll get someone being like, are you okay? And I'm like, no, I'm actually fine. I wrote the song, maybe I wasn't so fine at the time, but I think writing the song helped me be okay again. And I like to think that, you know, if somebody was listening, they would understand that whole thing of sometimes life is really rough and you can feel like all the things that used to make you happy just don't for a little while. There's just something they're not feeding your soul the way they normally do, but eventually it will come back. Like it always does. It's a circle. All my life's a circle, you know? So yeah, that's just how it is. The last song, or not the last song, the second last song that I'm going to play today is by another one of my inspirations, somebody that only in the last year, I'd say, I've gotten really, like really, really into as a singer and a musician. She's a Scottish folk singer called Eddie Reader. And actually it was a family member who told me that I should really listen to her. And at the time I was like, yeah, yeah. And then a few months later, which is often the way it happens, somebody will tell me to do something and I forget about it. But a few months later when I did listen, I was just struck by how amazing she is. And I had the pleasure of seeing her perform back in, I think, March of this year. And she's unbelievable. She added a whole other layer to what I thought being a musician was, or what it could mean as a live performer. Just because you could see how much fun she was having every single second that she was up on that stage. And that's kind of my goal, is to be like that with my music and life. So this is Eddie Reader's, my version of Eddie Reader's version of A Fond Kiss, and I really hope you like it. I'll try and make sure that I've got like a little auto scroll thingy on my laptop so that I can read the words while I sing, because I'm a cheater.
A fond kiss and then we sever. A farewell and then forever. Deep in heart wrung tears, I'll pledge thee. Warring sighs and groans, I'll wage thee. Who shall say that fortune grieves him? Why? star of hope, she leaves him. Mine cheerful twinkle lights me. Dark despair around benights me. I'll ne'er blame my partial fancy, for nothing could resist my Nancy. But to see her was to love her. Love but her, and love forever. Fare thee well, thou first and fairest. Fare thee well, thou best and dearest. Thine be like joy and treasure. Peace and joy, and love and pleasure. Had we never loved so kindly, had we never loved so blindly, nor never met, nor never parted. We had ne'er been broken hearted. A fond kiss, and then we sever. A farewell, and then forever. Deep in heart, wrung tears, I'll pledge thee. Warring signs and groans awake thee.
Thank you. That's a sad one. That's a very sad one. It's real. Parting ways,
but it was just beautiful.
Thank you.
I loved it, and I think other people did too. I see lots of smiles out there.
Oh good, I hope so. Thank you all.
So what is your last song for today?
My last song today is a song that I wrote when I was about 16. That's
oh, I love this one. Yes.
Yeah, it's called The Musician, and it's exactly what it says on the tin. It's all about knowing who you are and feeling that you will always be that in spite of everything. I'm just going to double check that my guitar is tuned properly. I think it is. Sometimes when you move a capo around on the neck of a guitar, the strings are slightly flat or slightly sharp. So it just sounds like a little bit off, which can be really infuriating. So there we go. Okay.
I swear that I'm a musician, but I've forgotten how to sing. I've forgotten how to play. I've forgotten everything. But a bird is still a bird, even if its wings fall off. And I would have been a musician if I was ever good enough. It's a sad sort of longing for the cake you didn't eat, or the man you never kissed, on the street you'll never meet. But a bird is still a bird, even if it's with regret. And I would have been a musician if by God I had been led. But I put down my guitar at the age of 23, and all my childhood dreams went and abandoned me. But a bird is still a bird, even if it has been caged. And I'll always be a musician, even if not on a stage. And I know I love to play, and I'll always be a musician, even if no one knows my name.
Thank you.
Wow, Caoimhe. Awesome. And to imagine that you wrote that when you were 16, and the line about putting your guitar down when you're 23. I mean, come on, lady. How did you do that?
I know. I was like, I think for a long time I was really afraid that I'd let the fear stop me, that I'd let it stop me from being who I am. I think I got over that. I realized that you can be afraid, but you do it anyway.
Right. And that's why the song is magnificent, because you're singing it, and I know it's the 16-year-old you who's nervous and there, and here you are singing it, and you can sing it still because it was what you thought then. And it's, you know, it's still a piece of you. It was beautiful. Thank you so much. You got lots of love in the chat. So thank you for being here. We love when you come on, and we hope to see you again very soon.
I hope so. Thank you.
We will talk to you. I'm going to now take a chance, and I'm going to say bye-bye, Caoimhe.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, thanks for being here. And I am adding to our spotlight today a new performer for Jeff's Place. Woo! Robb, we're really, really glad to have you. We're glad you could be here. I don't know much of your background, so I'm going to leave you to the stage, and please tell our audience all about who you are and how you got here and what you're going to sing about.
Okay. Can you hear me? Well, firstly, thank you, Lauren and Jeff, for having me here. My name is Robb, and my nickname is Robbie T, which is kind of how I came about being called the Raw Beats. It's just a play on Robbie T, Raw Beats. And I play banjo and foot drums, which is why I'm kind of zoomed out, because I like to show the drums. And even though banjo is now my primary instrument, I'm not really as fixated on bluegrass as people would expect a banjo player to be, but I love bluegrass and old time music and stuff. But everything I'm going to play here today will be off my latest CD, which is a banjo CD. I had a band accompany me. And anyway, I'm coming to you from Pungo, Virginia, and also spent a lot of time in the mountains, up in the Blue Ridge Mountains, a place called Tyro, Virginia, which is pretty much where all these songs were conceived and written. This first one is called Ours Are Ours. Ours. It's kind of hard to say. It's a tongue twister. But it's just basically about enjoying every hour in your day and the time. Really, time is the only thing we have. And just appreciating every hour of life that we can spend together by ourselves or however we do it. So ours are ours. Here we go. There's only so many hours in a day, only so many hours in a day. Oh, baby, won't you come and stay right here? There's so much hours in a day. There's only so many steps in a mile. There's so many steps in a mile. Baby, won't you come walk by my side? There's so many steps in a mile. People walking around with their head hung down like there's nothing to see. Well, honey, we could try to take a little time, make a melody. Baby, won't you spend a little time with me? We'll take what's ours in a day. There's so many people in the world, so many people in the world. Well, baby, won't you come and be my joy? There's so many people in the world, so many fishes in the sea, so many yummy fishes in the sea. Well, baby, dive in and come with me. Yeah, there's so many fishes in the sea. People walking by with their head held high like there's nothing to see. Honey, you and I could take a little time, make a memory. Baby, won't you spend a little time with me? We'll roll away the hours of the day. Let's roll one. Walking by with their head held high, too proud to see. Honey, you and I could make a little rhyme and a melody. Baby, won't you spend a little time with me? We'll take what's ours in the day. Now there's so much hours in the day. Oh, so much hours in the day. Baby, won't you come and be my joy? There's so much hours in the day. Only so much love in the world. There's only so much love in the world. Baby, won't you make a little love with me and make a boy happy in the world? Joy to the world. Oh, the boys and girls. Joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea. Joy to you and me. Joy to the world. Oh, the boys and girls. Joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea. Joy to you and me. Joy to the world. I kind of stole that last part, obviously.
That was awesome, Robb. Thank you so much. And I love the line you stole. It's one of my favorites.
All right, so cool. Next, I will do, I'll just go out on a limb here. I like trying to introduce new forms of the banjo that aren't, you know, the traditional forms of it, and that's kind of my musical MO. But outside of that, you know, I have a lot of problems with the political division in our country, in our world, and whatever. And I know that hot topic, but anyway, this is a song that I think, you know, we could all relate to getting back to. It's called Seasad, which is a abbreviation for common sense and decency. And I think that we could all just adopt those two principles back into our world, and we all have a, I don't know, enough of that. It's called Seasad. It goes a little something like this. Castaways thinking about the good old days, but sometime back we got a bit off track. The time rolls on, you're never gonna get it back. But I believe that things are gonna be fine in time. Work all day, what do you get? Rode hard, put up wet, I need lottery luck. Beer costs 15 bucks, it's all the rage. But not on minimum wage. But I believe that things are gonna be a-okay. No way. Left, right, big snafu. Wop, bop, a loop, bop, a loop, bamboo. You gotta pick your side, baby, in the great divide. Feels like sin, nobody wins. I believe that things are gonna be swell to tell. Beat on the bully, beat on the gong. Ride like old King Kong. Beat on the bully, beat on the gong. Smoke them up like Cheech and Chong. Hit them down low, sing them a song. Left is right and right is wrong. We're gonna get you back. Hey! Oh, my country, tears for thee. We need common sense and decency. We could start a fad. Wouldn't that be rad? What I see, it just makes me sad. Gonna be great again. Pipelines, corporate whores, dirty politicians, and winnable wars. Unless you're full of dough like a big fat CEO, they don't pay their share. The money trickles down, I'm told. Yeah, right. I believe that things are gonna be great. Around like old King Kong. Bet on the black, bet on the white. Far out, baby, out of sight. Hit them down low, sing them a song. Left is right and right is wrong. We're gonna get you back. Hey! Hey, fly, fiddle-dee-die. Gonna eat you up like a hog meat pie. What's your desire? The whole world's on fire. What I see, yeah, the whole world's on fire. But I believe that things are gonna be fine in time. I believe that things are gonna be a-okay. No way. I believe that things are gonna be swell.
Oh hell.
I believe that things are gonna be great again, again, and again.
Bye.
Had to put that in there. All right.
I love the sentiment in that one. It was great.
Thank you.
Well done.
Okie dokie. So this next one is called The Flood, parentheses, The Fire Next Time. And it was inspired by a horrible flood up in Nelson County, Virginia, in the Blue Ridge Mountains in 1969. That, if you look that up, Hurricane Camille, it was horrible and devastating. And then I just started thinking about other things about floods and not to get all biblical and whatnot, but you know, supposedly the earth was destroyed mostly by a flood when people got all wretched. And I was wondering, well, what? A rainbow means there's a promise that'll never happen again, but what would a God do if he had to get rid of us again before the planet kicks us off herself? And my father turned me onto a book called The Fire Next Time by James Baldwin. And I thought, well, maybe that's how they do it. I mean, we're burning it all up on our own anyway. So my heart goes out to the Canadians that are experiencing those horrible fires and everybody affected by that, which we have a little of it here in Virginia, but not as bad as most. Anyway, my good friend did a really lovely video of this that's on my website. Sorry to plug that, but anyway, it's called The Flood, The Fire Next Time, and it goes like this.
Cold shot ass
I saw rainbows in the fire next time. And the spaceship came to load them up
That was so much fun. And I mean, I know it's about a serious topic, but that's what it was so well done. Thank you so much. Do you have one more song for us?
I have one more, if you'll allow it.
Of course we will. Go to it.
Okay, this is kind of a serious topic too, but not really. I'm kind of trying to poke some fun at some of my friends who, believe it or not, you might also have this in your life where you have friends who don't politically see eye to eye. And you might be friends with both of them, and then maybe they don't get along so good outside of that, which is silly, I think. So I wrote a song about it. It's called The Good Ones, and it is about two of my friends, Jimmy and Johnny. That's not their real names, or maybe it is. And anyway, I think you'll figure it out from the lyrics. Thanks again for having me here. Pandas are real hard to tune, by the way. Steve Martin joked once, what's the difference between a car and a banjo? And he said, you can tune up a car. Anyway. The Good Ones goes a little like this.
Sometimes the good ones come unglued, but hey, it's gonna be okay. But Jimmy never did like Johnny's kind anyway. Well, Johnny sat back and he said, nix, nix, ain't gonna talk no politics. Jimmy said, son, I got a world to fix. That's how it goes with the hippies and the crits. Hey, it's gonna be okay. Same old skit, only on a different day. Hooray, it's gonna be alright. Sip a little wine by the fire on a Saturday night. One for my honey and two for my bro. Free to get crazy now, go dog go. Jimmy asked Johnny, do you like my hat? Johnny said, nope. Now how about that? One for the monkey, gonna make me eat crow. Hanging on my shoulder like an old banjo. Jimmy asked Johnny, do it make me look fat? Johnny said, yup. Now how about that? Hey, it's gonna be okay. Jimmy never did like Johnny's kind anyway. Hooray, it's gonna be alright. Pick a few tunes on the porch on a Saturday night. Let's go. Thank you. Jimmy did too, one in red and the other in blue. Did it like his vibe or his attitude. Sometimes the good ones come unglued. Johnny sat back and he said, "Nix, nix, ain't gonna talk no politics." Jimmy said, "Son, I got a world to fix." That's how it goes with the hippies and the crits. Hey, it's gonna be okay. Jimmy never did like Johnny's kind anyway. Hooray, it's gonna be alright.
Hooray!
Little nipper shine and a toke on a Saturday night. Yep. 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 Nope. Story of Jimmy and Johnny.
Oh, there. Sorry. Sorry about that delay. That was awesome. I love that story. And yep, I know just what you're talking about.
People do.
Oh yeah, it's been a pleasure to have you on our show. We look forward to having you back very soon. Thank you for sharing your magic with us.
Thank you.
We'll be in touch, and we'll send you some more dates, and then we'll get it to work. So thank you so much, Robb. It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Pleasure is all mine.
Whoops, wait a second. You're supposed to, there we go. And next on our stage today is Kerrie. Hey, Kerrie, how are you? Oh, you got to unmute yourself, love. It should let you do it. There you go. Great. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Welcome back. It's good to have you. The best thing to do is to have you introduce yourself to the audience so that they know a little bit about you. Your stuff is in the chat and you go to it.
All right. So I'm Kerrie Stelly, and I've been co-writing with we became very good friends, Kerrie Johnson. And so for like 6 years now, and what happens is I write lyrics and she kind of comes up with the melody. Like I have a basic melody and she'll kind of works her magic with it, and also arranges. Like sometimes she'll see words in my songs and be like, well, that'll go there, you know. So it's just the collaboration. It's great. And about 6 years. And then I've done open mics and some festivals, I've done one festival. I'm gonna do an acoustic night too in September with her, actually. And so anyway, that's about what's going on with me. And it was so great to hear Caoimhe, your beautiful voice, and then Robb, oh my gosh, that was like so fun dancing and everything. So and so I've played originals on here before. I'll do one or two. Now you know what, maybe I'll throw in a couple covers too. And so the first one is called You Can Sleep While I Drive. Growing up, I heard something when I was a teenager. I heard a friend was playing a CD, and I'm like, who is that? I'm like, wow, I like that songwriting. I like those words, and I like her songwriting style. And then it's Melissa Etheridge, and she, my husband and I went to see her a couple times. She just rocks it. But then she also has the slow down songs too, and this is one of those. So.
Come on, baby, let's get out of this town. Got a full tank of gas. With the top rolled down, there's a chill in my bones. I don't wanna be left alone. So baby, you can't sleep while I drive. I'll pack my bag and load up my guitar. In my pocket, I'll carry my heart. I got some money I saved, enough to get underway. Baby, you can't sleep while I drive. We'll go through Tucson, up to Santa Fe. And Barbara in Nashville says we're welcome to stay. I'll buy you glasses in Texas, a hat from New Orleans. And in the morning, you can't tell me your dreams. You know I've seen it before. This mist that covers your eyes. Been looking for something that's not in your life. My intentions are true. Won't you take me with you? Baby, you can't sleep while I drive. Oh, 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 is it other arms you want to? Oh, oh, hold you, a stranger, the lover you're free. Can't you get that with me? Come on, baby, let's get out of this town. I've got a full tank of gas with the top rolled down. If you won't take me with you, I'll go before night is through. Baby, you can't sleep while I drive. Oh, baby, you can't sleep while I drive.
Wow, Kerrie, that was absolutely beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Sorry, you can tell this is not Lauren's voice. I've actually hopped into Lauren's hosting seat from all the way over here in Ireland just for the next few minutes. That was absolutely stunning. I've never listened to Melissa Etheridge before, but I definitely will after hearing that. She's been recommended to me. So now you've kind of motivated me to listen to her. Thank you so much for that. What's the next song you're going to play? Is it a cover or an original?
Another cover, and then I'll do a couple. But this is, I also like Jewel. But anyway, and it's called Sentence to Set. No, that's actually an original. I'm sorry. Standing Still. And it's a song about, like, oh, no, do they like me? Do they not like me? What's going on? You know, something's going on, but I don't know. So, anyway, let's see.
Super relatable.
Yeah.
I love it.
Right. Yeah, I think we can relate in different situations with that one. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, and I'm working on doing a different strum for this, but for now, I'm just doing this one. Okay. Cutting through the darkest night, my two headlights, trying to keep you clear, but I'm losing it here to the twilight. There's a dead end to my left, there's a burning bush to my right. You aren't in sight. You aren't in sight. Do you want to? I want you, or am I?
the darkened sky? Or am I standing still with the scenery flying by? Or am I standing still out of the corner of my eye? Was that you passing me by? Mother's on the stoop, boys in souped-up coops on this hot summer night. Between fight and flight is the blind man's sight, a choice that's right. I'll roll the window down, feel like I'm gonna drown in this strange town. I feel broken down. I feel broken down. Do you need me? Love, need you? Or am I standing still beneath the darkened sky? Or am I standing still with the scenery flying by? Am I standing still out of the corner of my eye? Was that you passing me by? Sweet sorrow is a call tomorrow. Sweet sorrow is a call tomorrow. Do you love me? Love you? Or am I standing still beneath the darkened sky? Or am I standing still with the scenery flying by? Or am I standing still out of the corner of my eye? Was that you passing me by? Are you passing me by? Do you need me like I need you to? Do you want me like I want you? Are you passing me by?
Awesome. Well done, Kerrie. Oh my God, I loved it.
Oh, thanks.
I hope you don't mind me saying you sing with a real authenticity and a real kind of honesty in the way you sing, in that, like, when you're singing those covers, it's, you can feel the songs, you can really feel the words that you're singing, and I think that's a really special gift to have as a as a performer. Yeah, and I think that when you get the pleasure of hearing somebody doing a cover of something, you don't always get to hear their version. You sometimes hear too close to the original, and I think it's so much more beautiful to really hear a person shining through in a song that they didn't necessarily write, and you definitely have that gift. So thank you so much. I'm really looking forward to hearing your originals now as well.
Okay. I think I might have done this, but I'm gonna do it again. All right. This is one of my newer ones. It's the third newest. We're working on another new one, but okay.
We met in October '93. We were living in a two-room. family. I was busy trying to finish school, playing it oh so cool. With your sweet smile, picked up lines. Wasn't long until I called you mine. I got caught up in your dreams, fell for you like falling leaves. You were down on your knees with a pretty ring. Then your lies ruined everything. Now you're back out of the dark. Your remains just missed the mark. It's your confession, the inspiration, when it gives you validation, mixed with truth and lies. But after all these years, I've stopped crying. You ripped my heart open wide. All those secrets that you denied. I was told, should I leave or stay? Your restless soul sealed our fate. I held on for a while, then I let you go. And hit the road with your travel show. And now you're back, telling me your truth. Deep inside, I've forgiven you. As my train leaves the station, I'll ride for free with my validation. I moved on with my life. And after all these years, I've stopped crying. Found a man who loves me right. We raised a family side by side. I've got no doubt in my mind. I have everything that you took in stride. Deep inside, I've forgiven you. As my train leaves the station, I run for free with my validation. I've moved on with my life. And after all these years, I've stopped crying. After all these years, I've stopped crying.
I don't know if I have
time. That was great, sweetheart.
Thank you. Do I have time for one more? No.
How many? I just came back because I had to run for a second. Okay. Did you do two or did you do three?
I did three, yeah.
I think you have time for one more.
Okay. This is... This is the title song of my EP called Honor that's on Spotify and all the streaming, Apple Music, all the streaming platforms. Okay. I actually haven't played it out that much, so.
Looking at you, I see someone who makes my world a better place. Do it all with integrity and grace. Your gentle and giving heart, you realize the happiness you bring. And you make me believe I can fly with or without my wings. I am so honored. honor, and blessed to be by your side. I know that God did something right, because you changed my life. I am so honored, finally found my faith, just when I thought my hope would fade. You see me through another day. Put the smile back on my face. Feels so good to share my dreams with you. Ones I never thought could come true. Now I'm reaching for the stars, knowing you're there to catch me if I fall. It's rare to find someone like you at all. I am so honored, blessed to be by your side. I know that God did something right, because you changed my life. I am so honored, finally found my faith, just when I thought my hope would fade. You see me through another day, right where I belong. Keeping me strong. Standing together as one. I am so honored, blessed to be by your side. I know that God did something right. Baby, you changed my life.
Thank you so much, Kerrie, for being here today. We're glad to have you back, and we look forward to seeing you again. Thank you for sharing your beautiful music with us.
Thank you.
Thanks. Have a good rest of your afternoon. And now it's my pleasure again to welcome someone new to our stage. And for the first time, we welcome, let me just unmute you, sorry. Let's see if I can do that for you. Huh, hold on. I probably can, I gotta figure this out. More, Just one second. Sorry, everybody. Dan asked me to unmute and I am stuck. I think I have to undo this first, hold on. Let's see if I could do it now. Oh, maybe I can do it this way. Oh, there's my Nina. I might not be able to unmute you from here. I don't know why. If anybody has a suggestion or has seen this before.
Mute.
Ah, there you are. You're back. Ah, no, you're muted again. Yay!
Hey, aloha. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you now. Sorry. My Nina, I have a little one visiting me. Aloha. My neighbor's here. So she needed to come to visit. Her mom's not feeling so good. So she's blocking in and out. But she's here for the music, too, and she loves it.
I love to make music for the little ones.
Oh, all music is great for the little ones. Welcome to our show. It's a delight to have you. And you can introduce yourself better than I can. So I'm going to jump off and welcome you to our stage for the first time. And please tell our audience all about you.
Okay, mahalo, Lauren. Aloha, nui loa. My name is Dayan Kai, like day in, day out. And I'm born here on the island of Maui. I'm a full-time touring singer, songwriter, multi-instrumentalist, record producer, recording engineer, father of four, happily married to my sweet Maya. And we live here on the north shore of Maui, deep in the jungle. It's an honor to be here. And I've been doing this for many years. I've collaborated with a lot of folks that some of you may be familiar with. I perform often with my dear friend Keith Greninger, who's a singer-songwriter, award-winning singer-songwriter from Santa Cruz. I'll be touring in July with the great Joe Craven, who's a former percussionist and fiddler of the David Grisman Quintet and worked a lot with Jerry Garcia and those folks. And Joe and I are going to be doing some shows in July. And so anyway, that's a little bit about me. I'm a full-time multi-instrumentalist. I play all four families of instruments. I started on the piano when I was two, and I play woodwinds and brass, as well as many stringed instruments, the banjo, mandolin, violin, etc. And so I like to tell people whenever I'm doing whatever I'm doing that I'm just a confused piano player trying to get along. I hope you enjoy some of my original music, and I'll try to keep the talking short and keep the music long. This is a song I put out a couple of years back now, one of my latest singles. I do have several albums, both by myself and with others. So if you go to anywhere, if you type my name into the browser, you'll find it. I do urge folks, if you're interested, to please subscribe to my YouTube. That really helps a lot with visibility and helps you see and hear some of the things I'm up to. This is a song I wrote, as I was saying, called Losing Our Way. And it's actually a song more about the great things about life that we want to keep track of.
Light come down on the mountain. Don't you wanna know? Water sweet from the fountain. Listen to it flow. Losing our way. Game that we're playing with our love. Loving my sweet woman, spread it all around. Music all. What a joyous sound. We're losing our way. The game that we're playing with our love. food to nourish my body. Help the young to grow. There will be peace in the valley. Don't you wanna know? We're losing our way. Game that we're playing with our lives, losing our way. Game that we're playing with our lives, with our lives.
That was beautiful, Dayan. That was so cool.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So exciting to have you here. Thank you so much for being part of our amazing artists.
Well, it's my pleasure to be part of this, and I'm sure grateful that there's things like this happening in this world, and that new artists and good folks get to find out about one another and share what they're up to. And so thank you for what you're doing. It's wonderful. Sorry for all the clunks and clatter here. I'm a little boxed in with equipment and such. But no, this is really my pleasure. I'm going to, if it's all right with you, I'll play this song. I wrote this song while I was living in the west side of Maui in Lahaina town. Here on Maui, we have a very serious houseless problem. And it's something I spent many years living in the town of Santa Cruz and working a lot in the Monterey Bay, as well as spent a lot of my childhood in the town of San Juan Bautista. Anyway, homelessness or houselessness is something I'm very passionate about. I think in this land of abundance, there's absolutely no reason why people don't have access to things like food and clothing and dry shelter. And so one of the great artists I admire and had the pleasure to get to know a little bit is the late, great Utah Phillips, Bruce Utah Phillips, who actually started something in Nevada City, California, that's called the Hospitality House. That's a wonderful place where folks can go. And I think he inspired a lot of people to do that sort of thing. But I wrote this song about the subject of houselessness, and it was inspired by a gentleman who lived in Lahaina that folks called the Purple Man. And he used to walk around even in the 90 degree heat in a purple kind of a velvety suit. And one day my children came up to me, my two older children came up and said, Dad, our friends say that Purple Man's really, really bad. And I said, oh, really? What does he do? And they said, well, he eats children. And I thought for a moment, this is one of those moments, you know, where you've got to be a good dad and really come up with something good. I thought for a moment, I said, do you really think he eats children? They said, yeah, well, you know, that's what people say. And I said, well, have any of your friends gone missing? And they said, well, no. And I said, come on, guys, he doesn't eat children. Don't you think, you know, it's a small town. Don't you think word would get around? And I thought I'd really got it licked. I was very proud of myself. I thought I was a real good, you know, wise papa. But my kids are pretty akamai. They're pretty smart. And they came back about 15 or 20 minutes later and they said, hey, Dad. I said, what? And he said, well, what if he only eats the tourists? And then no one would know, you know. So about a week or two later, we actually had a chance. We were walking back from the ice cream parlor and we had a short moment to sit down and speak with the Purple Man. And he told us a little bit of his story. And it was a great moment for my kids. And it inspired me a lot. And of course, his story was a lot like the many stories I've heard from houseless individuals all over the world that I've traveled. And of course, he came from a fairly good family and had some education, and things went from bad to worse. And that can happen to a lot of us. And so it's this song is kind of a reminder that we all should try to be a little more compassionate toward folks and not always assume the worst about someone because of the state that they appear to us to be in. So this song is called Giving My Time Away. Long-winded explanation for a short song.
Here I sit upon this old park bench, underneath a shady tree. Safe here from the burning sun, but not the troubles facing me. I'm leaving on the midnight train, though there ain't no rails to roam. You might think I'm homeless, but I'm going home. What do you do? Is that all you can think to say? I'm all out of money, I'm just giving my time away. Them children say such awful things about the deeds that I've done. They don't know I was a daddy once, how I lost my son. I still don't know what for. Now he's gone and I'm still standing here. That's just one of life's closed doors. What do you do? Is that all you can think to say? I'm all out of money, I'm just giving my time away. Now I'm sitting on this old seashore, I got that water to my thighs, and them memories come and fill my head, and them tears they fill my eyes. I'm leaving on the old westbound, gonna take me back to where I'm from. Yeah, I'm standing on the cosmic highway, I'm holding out a thumb. What do you do? Is that all you can think to say? Giving my time away. What do you do? Is that all you can think to say? I'm all out of money, I'm just giving my time away. I'm standing on the cosmic highway, I'm holding out the standing
on the cosmic highway. Hallelujah. Above. Okay, hold on.
She's also known as the Linen Witch. Absolutely beautiful.
Thank you so much. That was gorgeous. And I think that the explanation was incredible and made such a difference in understanding too what the story is all about. So thank you
so much. Thank you. Let me pull an awkward move here. Just a sec here. Well, here's a little number I wrote many years back. I had the opportunity to go up the Waihe'e River here on Maui with my mother and a couple of friends. And I just lost my mom last May, and so this song took on even more meaning for me. But as we were going up the riverbed, it was pretty dry, and while we were up there, it started to rain, and the river started to flow, and it started to make the most beautiful music. And I thought to myself, this is sky music, and it's sky water, and this water has never been here before. And I got very inspired, and I got in the buff, and I jumped in the water, or laid in the little pool, I should say. I couldn't really jump. And this song sort of came to me. And I at first wrote this song on a djembe, on a drum. And my Hawaiian is not very good. It's something I'm working on, practicing to learn the language. As I said, I was born here on the island of Maui. For many, many years, the Hawaiian language was illegal. And that's, if you want to destroy a people and really eradicate their culture, making their language illegal is a really good way to do that. And so the result of that is that there are only about 3% of the population of the state of Hawaii that speak any Hawaiian. And there's only about 1.8% of the indigenous population left. Most of them have moved to Las Vegas and Utah and places like that that are more affordable, because the cost of living here is astronomical, unfortunately. So anyway, I wrote this song called I Can Make It Rain. And it's about magic. It's about the feeling you have when you're home. I know this is something Caoimhe can probably relate to a lot. And Robb as well, being in Virginia and those beautiful mountains, and being in County Cork, these beautiful parts of the world where we have access to wonderful nature and things like that. There's a magic that we feel when we're home. There's a smell and a feeling we get. And so that's what this song is about. And so because my Hawaiian wasn't very good, I contacted my auntie and I said, Auntie, how would Hawaiians say the river song loves the rain? Because that's what I wanted to say. And she said, well, Hawaiians don't say that. And so I said, okay, Auntie, well, if Hawaiians did say that, how would they say it? And she said, well, I don't know. And so we kind of came up with some Hawaiian together for this song. And I've since lost my dear Auntie B, but she was a great kapuna and a great teacher. And we used to have a Hawaiian group called the Ohanas in the Monterey Bay many years back. But anyway, all I can say as to whether the Hawaiian is correct is no bradas have pounded me yet for singing this song. So I still, and some of them sing along with me. So there's some Hawaiian at the very end. And please sing along with me. This is a sing-along song. The words are, I can make it rain. I can make it rain. When I go back home, I can make it rain.
I can make it rain. I can make it rain. can make it rain when I go back home. I can make it rain. Why mele ke aloha ua? 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 When I go back home, I can make it rain. When we go back home, we can make it rain. When I go back home, I can make it rain.
Wow. Unbelievable. And you might not have heard the chat, but in the chat, you got lots of good stuff. And it started to rain by Robb as you started to sing.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
And Caoimhe said, you're right, because the same thing happened in Ireland in terms of the language. And there's a proverb, which I won't try to say, but Caoimhe, if you're listening, you can open up and say, but she said the translation is a country without a language is a country without a soul.
That's it. That's it.
Can you guys hear me? I can tell you.
Yes, we can hear you.
Ooh, okay. So it's Tirgon Changa, Tirgon Anam.
Ah.
Yeah, country without a language. Yeah, that's it exactly.
Well, we're distant cousins, I think.
Awesome. I absolutely love it. You're amazing.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Have I got time for one more, or are we Pau?
Yes, you have time for one more. We would love it.
All right. I'll do the title track to my last album that I put out. It's called To Be Free. Whoops, I've got a little situation here. Hang on. the cables. There we are. Sorry about that. This is a song I wrote, again, just about celebrating the beauty, the goodness, and if we don't take joy and pleasure in life, it'll pass us by and we'll miss it. So it's all about being present, and so that's what this song is about for me. Thank you.
got so much work to do before they see that owning and possessing is just a sick fantasy. Oh, my brothers and sisters, I am so grateful just to help you stand that we are here and we are free. I will help you stand, we are here and we are free. Oh, my people, I am so grateful to be alive, to be here, and to be free. 'Cause we're alive, we are here, and we are free. You and me, we're alive, we are here, and we are free. You and me, we're alive, we are here, and we are free. You and me, we're alive, we are here, and we are free.
Wow, what a beautiful song to end our show. That was amazing. I'm going to bring up our performers.
Thank you so much.
So that
thank
we
you
can,
for having me.
Thank you for allowing my little Nina to be here too. She's sort of like floating in the back. Wait, where is my
Cleaver? She's here.
Oh, she loves the music. Yay! Yes, I hear you. Too. Yeah, we hear you. We hear you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It was a beautiful afternoon. Each and every one of your performances were amazing. And Caoimhe, thanks for jumping in for me. I appreciate that so, so much. And we look forward to having you back. You want to say hi? You can't scream, but you can say quick hi. Say hi. No. See, that's where we're going. I love that's you guys.
No.
Thank you so much for
aloha,
everything.
You guys. Thank you all for all your efforts and keep up the great work and keep supporting one another.
Thank you. And we can't wait to have all of you back. It would be an honor to have everybody back. So you tell me when is good and we will make it work. Thanks again. And thanks to our lovely audience. Thank you for joining us today. And we look forward to seeing you in the future. Everybody stay safe. Whoops, I'm just trying to end the broadcast over here. The mouse isn't working.